Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Ordinarily, this is not a video I programmed for today, but because of what happened yesterday, I felt like let me just do a chit chat. Election 2019, Nigeria decides. Who else freaked out? The moment they heard that they're not having the election yesterday. Where do we start from? I feel like, okay, this is a rant. Like, I just want to talk. I feel like, you know how you feel like you need to talk? I feel like, where, how do I say this and it would, okay, how about I pick up my camera, I set up my camera and I talk to my camera. So, this is Nigeria Decides Part 1. I don't know if it's going to be a series or something, but as long as we're in this electoral period, I think I'm going to do this. So, I'm going to start with cancelling the presidential election about 3 or 4 hours to the time. I think it's supposed to start around 7, 6, I think, because I'm a core member. You guys know that I'm serving my fatherland. So because I'm a core member, automatically, we're the ones they use. They just get outsiders, they train them to assist us. But for every APO, presiding officers, they are all core members. That's the head of every polling booth. How do you guys say it? Yes. Personally, I attended the first training, I attended the second one, and I realized that, okay, I went for the first training. I asked, I said, where do we sleep? And the woman, the trainee, what do I for the trainer? She didn't specifically say it like they're going to provide a place for us to sleep. And I knew that with the way she's saying, she said, you guys don't worry, you'll be fine. Auntie, where are we going to sleep? I did not say if we are going to be fine or not. I'm only asking, where are we going to sleep? And she didn't give me any tangible reason. I got back that day and I just spoke with my husband. I was just like, this is Nigeria. Anything goes. I'm not so sure they have plans for you guys. And that's how I wrote a letter to be exempted. Now, a lot of people didn't know that they could actually be exempted. My ally, the way my ally put the thing, she would say, she gave us all the rules and she now said, if you'd like to be exempted, you should write the letter and put the reason why you'd like to be exempted and submit it today. Like, that means if you don't submit it today, you can't submit it again. So a lot of people didn't see a reason, you know. I used medical reasons. A lot of people didn't have a reason, so they felt like you don't have a choice, that everybody wants to. And that's how they have that amount of core members who were in the old thing, only for them to get there yesterday on Friday, day before yesterday. And they had to videos, were taking pictures, they slept outside in the cold. And you guys know that lately the weather has been funny. So you wake up on the normal day that is supposed to be sunny and bright and you see Amatan. You wake up, sometimes it's raining. Dude, the weather has been funny lately. As if that was not enough, then they just cancelled the election on us just like that, and nothing is happening. Nobody's saying anything about it. So on the common group chat yesterday, somebody was now saying we should protest. I said, nobody forced you. I just wrote it there. I said, nobody forced you to do this thing, and it's never too late to back out. You don't even owe anybody anything. The only thing you can do that I think you can do is just gently carry yourself and your body. Next week, Friday, sleep in your father's house. If you think they already have your number, like the head, because some people are supposed to be the supervisors and all, which are those people are the INEC officials. If you think they have your number and they're going to call you, gently carry your phone, switch it off, put it in airplane mode, and sleep in your father's house. After everything, if they ask you why, you tell them that you were sick from the last one. I called one of my friends. She kept on shouting, my body's aching me. We slept outside. We did this. How much are they even paying them? As if that's not enough. The risk attached to it. The fact that there's no security. While we're doing the training, they said they're going to give every polling booth their own security personnel. Some people were sending in messages yesterday that there was no security on ground and they had sensitive and non-sensitive materials. I feel like Nigeria as a country, we can do better. And if these people, these politicians in question, I can bet it with you, their children are not in Nigeria. They've all journeyed. Like, they all traveled already. So why stress yourself? God forbid, but if anybody dies, now nobody sins. Nobody care. They don't care. I'm afraid they don't care. Come next week, you realize that your children are still not going to come back. They are just, these people just want to, whether they like it or not, they know you don't have a choice. I just feel like assurance. I'm not editing this video, I just upload it. You know, I just feel like core members should wake up to reality. If you want to do it, do it. If you feel you don't want to do it, switch off your phone, sleep in your house. If they call you, tell them that you are sick. Last, you go to one health center and obtain medical reports. That's how you couldn't attend. Some people can't, do you know, people came back and decided buying malaria treatment. Some people started feeling malaria immediately. People came back with blood stains of mosquito bites on their trousers. It's really bad. And the only thing you can do because if you don't do anything, they don't really care, they don't care about you. And about this old election, I think we should just play safe. We should just try to be on the safe side. Don't try to outdo yourself. Don't try to be, say you want to be the good Nigerian. It won't start with you, it won't end with you. These people, they're not worth fighting for. If you want to go out and vote, good for you. I don't have a PVC. I don't vote. I already wrote exemption letter, so somehow I'm just in my house chilling. I don't need to allow it. I cannot come and die. Anyway, guys, I just decided to talk to the camera and rant, vent my anger. I'll see you guys in my next video. Please do not forget to click the subscribe button, like, and share. Oh, no, the video I prepared for today was husband tag. Yeah, my husband, Valentine package for you guys. Maybe I'll do it next week. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.